back in 2006 called The Nativity Story. You can find it by Googling it, and it's also available on Amazon, and it's well worth getting a copy for you and your family. It focuses on the vulnerability and the humanness of Mary and Joseph, and how they become inseparably entwined with the divinity of the child that she's carrying. You see how, through their faith in God, they become the Holy Family through the birth of Jesus in the stable cave in Bethlehem. You see how they personally and totally give of themselves as gifts to the little baby Jesus. At the movie's end, they receive the three wise men who have come to worship him. The Magi reverently offer their gifts, quietly proclaiming the meaning of each to Mary and Joseph. Gold as the gift for a king, frankincense as the gift for a priest, and myrrh as the gift for the one who will be sacrificed. It also struck me that in their seeking out the baby Jesus, the Magi had also presented themselves as gifts to him as well. Bathed in the heavenly light that had led them there, not knowing all that we know now about what this tiny child would mean to all of humanity, they nevertheless prostrate themselves before this newborn king, humans with open hearts and minds encountering the divine. Our gospel today brings us to this special night when God came to us, enfleshed in our own flesh, God become man, yet remaining God as well. But the gospel today also tells us of the ways that people can choose to respond to Christ. Our Savior calls each of us to join into a sacred holiness with him, but he doesn't force it. It's for us to choose how we'll respond. He stands at the door of our souls and he knocks. But it's up to us to open and to let him enter into our lives. So let's first take a look at King Herod's reaction. And he chooses hatred and hostility. He's afraid this little child will interfere with his power and his influence. So his first instinct is to destroy him. Then there are those in this world today who would gladly denigrate and try to destroy Jesus Christ in the eyes of others, because they see in him the one who interferes with their lives. These people, whose principal desire is to do what they like to do, regardless of the consequences to themselves or others, they have no real use for our Lord. The second choice is the one made, I think, by the chief priests and the scribes. I think they choose indifference. It's these very same people who just recited to Herod the words of the prophet Micah, "And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Now, at the time of Jesus' birth, all of Israel was ripe with the hope of the coming of a saving Messiah. What if the prophecy that they themselves had just recalled to Herod had now really come true? As religious leaders of the Jews, wouldn't the possible long-awaited fulfillment of this prophecy demand investigation on their part? Well, you'd think so, but no, they were so caught up in their temple rituals, the old covenant laws, and the status quo of importance within their community that they completely disregard Jesus and just kind of let Herod go on his way. Today, there are Christians who know that the prophecy has come true in Jesus, but they react with indifference too. It's like they kind of keep Jesus up in a dusty old spice rack, infrequently used and not an important part of their spiritual lives. Then they occasionally take him down and sprinkle him into their lives as a temporary flavoring when they need him. The rest of the time, oh well. And today we also see the choice of the Magi, these pagan men from the East. They choose to personally invest themselves to work at searching out the newborn king. And when they find him, they pay him homage and adoring worship, laying at his feet the noblest gifts that they can bring: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And what about us, gathered here today beneath his crucifix? It's the solemnity of the Epiphany of the Lord. God comes to us and takes on our own very human flesh while remaining God himself. The day we celebrate God's revealing himself to the world through his Son, Jesus Christ. What choice will we make for the King of Kings, God's Son, who came into this world to sacrifice himself for our sake and to win for us the merciful crown of our eternal salvation? What choice will we make, not just on Sundays, but every single day of our lives? Just as the Magi gave him their homage and adoration, we should too during these days of Christmas and then every day of our lives. Let's offer him the most personal gift that we have to give, the gift that Mary and Joseph gave, the gift of our very selves. We can give ourselves to him by making conscious, personal choices for Jesus. Each and every day, we can rejoice in the joy of our baptisms, when he gave us new life, bathed in the grace of his saving life and power. We can believe in him with all of our hearts and minds and offer Jesus our homage and our adoration every day. We can make personal choices that have us live out God's commandments, to put Christ first and making decisions about our conduct by deciding in favor of what he came to teach and to show us. We can be living examples of the way of life, showing others around us that these choices aren't just some passing fancy, but they're how we choose to live our lives each and every day. And then we consciously and willingly point ourselves to what's truly important: love for God first, and then love for others, always by our thoughts, our words, and our actions. My friends, as we put away our decorations and the glow of our Christmas celebration becomes more muted as we all move into the cold months of winter, it mustn't be so of our belief in and our consciously practiced faith in Jesus. We need to keep these burning as brightly as the Christ candle over there burns beneath our altar and beneath his crucifix. Jesus asks us that we continually offer him the gift of our very selves so that he can offer himself fully as gift to us. And when we truly give ourselves to him, placing him first in our lives and in charge of him, his love and his mercy will surround us, and everyone we love will be the better for our having given ourselves to him as gift.